Welcome to Angel TV and also welcome to Crossfire.
欢迎收看天使电视，这是十架的火焰系列。
We are in a series and studies on the end times.
我们现在正在研究的是末日的一些事情。
And I pray that you will benefit as we look through the scriptures.
我祷告的是，当我们研读经文的时候，你能够得着福气和帮助。
May God begin to show to you as we prepare our hearts for the second coming of Jesus.
当我们的心预备好迎接主的再来的时候，愿主赐福给我们。
Today we are living in days and time of difficulties.
今天我们正活在一个困难处处的时代。
We see nations are rising up against nation.
我们看到国攻打国。
Lawlessness began to rise in the nation.
我们看到在国家的里面有不法的事情发生。
Earthquake.Happening in various parts of the world.
在世界的各处都有地震。
Epidemic began to wipe nations.
瘟疫也到处的蔓延。
People are living in fear.
许多人都活在恐惧当中。
With the AIDS, with the dengue, and with the sickness that arises.
艾滋病或者是这些的疟疾呢，不断的在侵蚀着人类。
The Bible is the only book in the world that gives us explicitly account of the end times.
只有圣经是世界上唯一的书卷，告诉我们末日是怎么样的。
As all these events unfold before our eyes,
当这些的事件一件一件被揭露的时候，
it must awaken us.
它必须叫我们警醒。
Keep our hearts ready.
叫我们的心能够预备好。
For Jesus Christ's return.
为着主的再来。
Today we're going to talk about the rapture.
今天我们要研究的是被提。
What is the meaning of the rapture?
被提是什么意思呢？
The Bible do not have the word rapture.
圣经里面没有被提这个词。
But the word rapture in the scripture, it been transformed from an earthly to a spiritual body.
圣经里面所谓的被提呢，就是我们这个地上的形体转变成属灵的形体。
Where a person is earthly body translated to a spiritual body and be caught up with the Lord in the air.
当一个人他地上的形体转变成属灵的形体的时候，他与主在空中相遇。
It is found in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16 and 17.
在帖撒罗尼迦前书第四章十六和十七节可以看到。
For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout,With the voice of an archangel and with the trumpet of God and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we, those who are alive and remain, shall be caught up together with him in the cloud and meet the Lord in the air, and thus shall we always be with the Lord.
帖撒罗尼迦前书四章十六和十七节，因为主必亲自从天降临，有呼叫的声音和天使长的声音，又有神的号吹响。那在基督里死了的人必先复活，以后我们这活着还存留的人必和他们一同被提到云里，在空中与主相遇，这样我们就要和主永远同在。
This is an account that Paul began to write to the Thessalonian church.
这是使徒保罗写给帖撒罗尼迦教会的书卷。
He said when the trumpet began to sound,
这里说当神的号角响起，
the dead in Christ will rise first.
那些在基督里死了的人必须先复活。
Then those who are alive will be caught up with the Lord in the air.
然后那些活着的还存留的人呢，必和主在空中被提相遇。
Those who are alive will not see death.
那些存留的人不会见死。
We have two examples in the Bible.
在圣经里面有两个例子。
That two men of God did not see death and were translated.
这两个人呢，他们并没有见死就被提与主相遇。
One is Enoch and the other one is Elijah.
一个是以诺，另外一个就是以利亚。
We see in Hebrews chapter 11 verse 5.
在希伯来书十一章第五节。
And by faith Enoch was translated so that he did not see death and was not found because God had translated him.For before his translation, he had his testimony that he pleased God.
以诺因着信被接去，不至于见死，人也找不着他，因为神已经把他接去了。只是他被接去以先，已经得了神喜悦他的名证。
This is the life of Enoch.
这就是以诺的生活。
He had an encounter with God.
他与神相遇。
He walked so close with the Lord.
他与神紧密的同行。
That the Bible says he did not die, but as he walked, God took him home.
这里说呢，以诺并没有见死。当他与神同行的时候呢，神就把他接去了。
Another person is Elijah.
另外一个人是以利亚。
We see in 2 Kings chapter 2 verse 11.
在列王记下第二章第十一节。
And it happened as they continued to talk, and suddenly a chariot of fire appeared with horses of fire, separated the two of them, and Elijah went up by the whirlwind into heaven.
列王记下二章十一节，他们正走着说话，忽有火车火马将二人隔开，以利亚就乘旋风升天去了。
These two accounts began to talk about the rapture.
这两个例子呢，让我们看到被提。
This account began to speak about two men who walked with God and was taken.
这两处的经文让我们看到有两个人，他们被神接去了。
Where Paul began to speak to us in Thessalonians that we have seen, when the trumpet shall sound, the dead in Christ shall rise, then believers will be caught up.
保罗在帖撒罗尼迦的书卷里面告诉我们，有一天神的号角吹响的时候，这些死人要先复活，然后那些存留着的人要被提到云中与主相遇。
These two accounts must inspire our life.
这两个例子必须要激励我们的生命。
We know that the first coming of the Lord has been a historical fulfillment.
我们知道主耶稣第一次的降临已经成为了一个历史的应验。
While the second coming of Jesus lies in the future.
而耶稣的再来呢，将是未来的事件。
What did Jesus say about the future?
到底耶稣对于未来说了什么？
In John chapter 14 verse 3.
耶稣在约翰福音十四章第三节说，
And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself.And where I am, there you will be also.
我若去为你们预备了地方，就必再来接你们到我那里去。我在那里，叫你们也在那里。
Here Jesus promised us in the future that he went and prepared a place for us. When we meet him, we will have our glorious home in heaven.
在这里，耶稣应许我们说，在未来的日子里面，他已经为我们预备了一个地方。有一天，当我们与他相遇的时候，我们将会去到那个地方。
That is why you and I, we need to have that desire in our hearts.
这就是为什么我们在心里面要有这种的渴慕。
Looking for the rapture to happen.
那就是盼望有一天被提的发生。
If we are not raptured, then we'll be left behind.
如果我们没有被提的话，我们将会留在地上。
And when we are left behind, we'll be at a time of great tribulation.
要是我们留在地上的时候，那将是经历最大的灾难。
And when there's great, great tribulation, there'll be great problems in this earth.
当有大灾难的时候，这个世界将会面对重大的问题。
Problem that men have never encountered in the history of mankind.
这些的问题是人类历史里头从来没有经历过的。
The great tribulation is the time where disaster after disaster will happen.
因为在大灾难的时间里面呢，灾难会接二连三的发生。
We see the Bible talks about the great tribulation.
我们看到圣经提到大灾难。
And I pray that we will not be in the great tribulation.
我所祷告的是，我们不会落在大灾难里头。
When the great tribulation happens, the Antichrist will begin to reign.
因为当大灾难临到的时候，敌基督就是作王了。
Many believers began to predict who would be the Antichrist.
很多的信徒都在预测谁是敌基督。
But the Bible gives us the big characteristic of the Antichrist.
但是圣经给我们非常详细的记录谁是敌基督。
As we see in the Bible.
我们可以在圣经里面看到。
In Philippians chapter 3 verse 18 and 19.
我们在腓立比书第三章十八和十九节可以看到。
For many walk of whom I've told you often,And now I tell you, even weeping, that they are the enemies of the cross of Christ, whose end is destruction, whose God is their belly, whose glory is in their shame, who set their mind on earthly things.
因为有许多人行事是基督十字架的仇敌，我屡次告诉你们，现在又流泪地告诉你们，他们的结局就是沉沦，他们的神就是自己的肚腹，他们以自己的羞辱为荣耀，专与地上的事为念。
Just as Paul began to say, this spirit of Antichrist are those who are the enemy of the cross.
保罗在这里所说的这些敌基督呢，就是基督十字架的仇敌。
They have no regard of God.
他们根本没有神在眼中。
Neither would they accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior.
当然，他们也不接受耶稣基督是救主，是主。
These are people who will deny the Jesus Christ came in the flesh.
他们也否定了耶稣基督是道成肉身来到世上。
And they will say that Jesus Christ is not God.
他们也说主耶稣基督不是神。
But Apostle John began to warn us and speak to us.
但是使徒约翰却在经文里面警告我们，告诉我们说
In 1 John chapter 4 verse 3.
在约翰一书第四章第三节。
And every spirit that does not confess that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is not of God. And this is the spirit of the Antichrist, which you have heard was coming and is now already in the world.
约翰一书四章三节，凡灵不认耶稣，就不是出于神，这是那敌基督者的灵。你们从前听见他要来，现在已经在世上了。
So John began to say, those who deny Jesus Christ that comes in the flesh is the Antichrist.
所以约翰在这里所说的那些否认耶稣是道成肉身的，就是敌基督的。
As we see in 1 John chapter 2, verse 22 and 23.
正如我们在约翰一书第二章二十二和二十三节所看到的。
Who is a liar but he who denies that Jesus is the Christ? He is the Antichrist who denies the Father and the Son. Whosoever denies the Son does not have the Father neither. He who acknowledges the Son has the Father also.
谁是说谎话的呢？不是那不认耶稣为基督的吗？不认父与子的，这就是敌基督的。凡不认子的，就没有父；认子的，连父也有了。
Here, Apostle John warned that many antichrists would rise up in the world.
在这里，约翰警告我们说，在这个世界上将有许多敌基督者兴起。
Not only in the world, but Apostle John began to warn those who are within the church.
不单只是世界上有，约翰。警告我们说，在教会里面也会有。
And we as believers, we need to know the word of God.
所以作为信徒，我们必须要认识神的话。
Jesus Christ is the Son of Man and the Son of God.
我们看到主耶稣基督是人子，也是神子。
100% God, 100% man.
百分之百的人，百分之百的神。
We will not fully understand the whole humanity and the whole Deity of Jesus.
我们根本无法测透主耶稣的人性和神性。
But the Bible presents Jesus Christ as Son of God and Son of Man.
但是圣经告诉我们，主耶稣基督就是人子，他同时也是神子。
Just as John the Apostle warned us in 1 John chapter 2 verse 18.
正如约翰在约翰一书第二章十八节给我们的警戒。
Little children, it is the last hour.That you heard that Antichrist is coming. Even now, many Antichrists have come, by which we know that is in the last hour.
小子们呐，如今是末世了。你们曾听见说那敌基督的要来，现在已经有好些敌基督的出来了。从此我们就知道，如今是末世了。
Today we are living in the days that the spirit of Antichrist is increasing.
今天我们活在的世代呢？敌基督的灵不断地增加。
They began to ridicule the doctrine of Christianity.
他们在那边呢，嘲笑基督教的教义。
But as you and I began to put our faith in the Lord Jesus.
可是当你和我把我们的信心建立在耶稣基督的里面。
As we put our faith in the Word of God.
当我们把我们的信心建在神的话语上。
And ask the Holy Spirit to illuminate our minds and our hearts.
然后求圣灵来启发我们的心和我们的灵。
That these are antichrists who reject the deity, the Godhead of Jesus.
凡是这些拒绝耶稣基督的，我们都要去抵挡他。
In the Old Testament, you have an example of the Antichrist spirit.
在旧约里面也有这种基督的灵出现。
These are the spirit of Antichrist. They reject with hatred in their heart.
这些敌基督的灵呢，他们的心里面充满了仇恨。
We see from the Bible.
我们从圣经里面看到
，Where Cain began to kill his brother Abel，
我们看到该隐杀了他的弟弟亚伯
，Out of envy and jealousy，
为着他的妒忌，他杀了弟弟。
In 1 John chapter 3 verse 12，
在约翰一书第三章十二节
，Not as Cain who was wicked one murdered his brother， and why did he murder him？ Because his works were evil and his brother's righteous。
不可像该隐，他是属那恶者，杀了他的兄弟。为什么杀了他呢？因为自己的行为是恶的，兄弟的行为是善的。
As we read First John chapter 2, chapter 3,
当我们读约翰一书第二章、第三章
，Apostle John began to talk about the spirit of Antichrist and get example from the Old Testament.
使徒约翰呢，他就提到了。敌基督的灵是怎么样的？然后就从旧约里面让我们看到这些例子。
That is why you and I we need to be aware that there are many people in the world with hatred and envy in their hearts.
所以我们要意识到，在世界上什么叫做敌基督的灵呢？就是那些充满了嫉妒、嫉恨的人。
Have you come across in your life when you preach the word of God, share the word of God, the antichrist spirit rises up?
你有没有经历过这样的事情呢？就是当你去分享福音的时候，这些敌基督的灵不断的兴起。
They reject Jesus.
他们拒绝耶稣。
They refuse to hear the word.
他们拒绝听神的话。
They deny Jesus Christ came in the flesh.
他们否认耶稣是道成肉身。
Now, as the Bible revealed to us, we are aware what is happening.
那当圣经告诉我们的时候，我们也意识到圣经所说的正在发生。
But as believers, we pray.
但是作为信徒，我们要祷告。
God will open their hearts.
神要打开他们的心。
Open their mind.
要打开他们的心思意念。
Open their spirit.
要打开他们的灵。
That they will have the revelation.
以至于他们能够得到神的启示。
And understanding.
并且有明白的心。
That Jesus Christ is the Son of God and came to save us.
他们要明白到耶稣基督是神的独生子，来到世上拯救世人。
We also need to know who is the Antichrist.
我们也必须认识到谁是敌基督。
The Bible gives us his identity and his purpose.
圣经让我们看到他的身份以及他来到的目的。
We have examined what constitutes the spirit of Antichrist.
刚才我们已经看到了什么组成这个基督的灵。
However, this is also...Help us to distinguish from the Antichrist himself.
但是我们也要看到辨别什么谁才是敌基督。
The Antichrist in the Bible is also known in the scripture as the beast.
在圣经里面，这个敌基督呢也被称为兽。
We see in Revelation the 13th chapter, verse 7 and verse 8.
在启示录十三章第七和第八节说。
And it was granted to him to make war with the saints and overcome them. And authority was given him over every tribe, tongue, and nation. And all who dwell on the earth will worship him whose names have not been written in the book of life of the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world.
又任凭他与圣徒征战，并且得胜，也把权柄赐给他制服各族、各民、各方、各国，凡住在地上，名字从创世以来没有记在被杀之羔羊生命册上的人，都要拜他。
As we read at this scripture,
当我们读这些经文
，The Bible say in verse 7, and it was granted to him to make war.
这里呢，在第七节说到。让他有权柄与圣徒征战。
It is so important to remember that God is sovereign.
我们要记得神是有至高的权柄。
And the Antichrist cannot come unless God give him the permission.
敌基督无法有作为，除非神容让他这样做。
And the Bible began to say such authority the Antichrist have.
这里就提到了这个敌基督所有的权柄。
He has authority on every tribe, every nation. Every nation will come under the Antichrist.
这里说到敌基督有所有的权柄，能够制服各民、各方、各国。
For those who dwell upon the earth do not worship him.
凡是住在地上没有敬拜他的。
Oh, he is going to slay those who do not worship him.
凡是没有敬拜他的，他都要杀害。
But I pray that we will not caught in that event.
但是我祷告的是，你和我都不会陷在这种状况。
For those who are caught in this event, they truly need the grace and the mercy of God to go through.
但是如果在这种境况中的人，他们真的需要神的恩典和怜悯来度过这一切。
One of the reasons for the Antichrist to come so that God will use the Antichrist to purify those believers who are left behind.
那其实神容让第一基督来到世上是为了让那些留在地上的信徒能够借着这个事情而追寻圣洁。
Because the prophet Daniel writes upon the day of the tribulation.
因为但以理他曾经说到这大灾难的时间。
In Daniel chapter 12 verse 10.
在但以理书第十二章第十节。
Many shall be purified and make white.And refined, but the wicked shall be wickedly, and none of the wicked shall understand, but the wise will understand.
但以理书十二章第十节，必有许多人使自己清净洁白，且被熬炼，但恶人仍必行恶，一切恶人都不明白，唯独智慧人能明白。
Though the prophet Daniel say the Antichrist reigned with terror in the last days.
先知但以理他说呢，有一天在末日的时候，敌基督要兴起。
In the time when the Antichrist reign and believe those people have opened their hearts to the Lord.
当有一天敌基督执政掌权的时候
，We need to pray that we are not caught in this event.
我们要祷告的是，我们不会遇到这样的状况。
For those who are tortured in the time of the Antichrist.
当那些人在敌基督的时候被熬炼。
They will be caught up. They will be with the Lord in heaven.
他们呢能够与主在空中。
Just as Revelation, the seventh chapter, verse 13 and 14 began to speak to us.
就好像启示录第七章所说的。
Then one of the elders answered, saying to me, "Who are these arrayed in white robes, and where did they come from?" And I say to him, "Sir, you know." So he says to me.These are the ones who come out of the great tribulation, wash their robes and make them white in the blood of the Lamb.
启示录第七章十三和十四节说，长老中有一位问我说，这些穿白衣的是谁？是从哪里来的？我对他说，我主你知道。他向我说，这些人是从大患难中出来的，曾用羔羊的血把衣裳洗白净了。
Those who stand firm for the Lord in the day of tribulation.
凡是在大患难中仍然站立的稳的
，Even though they were slain，
即使他们被杀
，When they die, they be with the Lord。
他们死的时候仍然与主同在。
We need to pray that God will give us strength。
我们要祷告神赐力量给我们
，Fervency in our hearts，
让我们的心里面有恒久忍耐的心。
In the time of crisis and persecution。
来到逼迫的时候
，Our faith will not waver.
我们的信心不会动摇。
Even though we may not be in the time of tribulation,
即使我们不在大患难中
，But right now,
就是现在
，We can pray God give us strength.
我们可以向神祷告，赐我们力量
，To live a life for you.
让我们为主而活。
Let us pray.
让我们一起祷告。
Father, I come to you today.
天父，今天我来到你面前。
In the name of Jesus.
奉耶稣的名来到。
Protect us.
主啊，求你保护我们。
Be with us.
与我们同在。
Put a hedge around every believers.
让你的恩膏来遮蔽每一个信徒。
In the time of crisis.
特别在灾难的时候。
In the time of need.
在我们有需要的时候。
You would protect them.
你保护我们。
You would strengthen them.
你会坚固我们。
They will not lose out.
使到我们不会失去信心
Their faith shall be strong
让我们的信心得以坚固
Lord let your grace and your hand be upon our lives
主啊愿你的恩手按手在我们身上
In Jesus name we pray
奉耶稣的名祷告
Amen
Amen
May God bless you
愿神赐福给你。
May God's grace be with you.
愿神的恩惠随着你。
May you be strengthened every day in the Lord Jesus Christ.
愿你每一天都在耶稣基督里面得力量。
Amen.
Amen.